Crocodiles, one of the most resilient and formidable predators to ever roam the earth, have survived for over 235 million years, enduring multiple mass extinctions and adapting to drastic environmental changes, including changing temperatures, rising sea levels, and the transformation of ecosystems over millions of years. These ancient reptiles are known for their powerful jaws, sharp teeth, and thick, armored skin, making them apex predators in their aquatic habitats. Found primarily in tropical and subtropical regions, crocodiles are remarkably adaptable and capable of thriving in both freshwater and saltwater environments. While modern crocodiles can grow up to 7 meters in length, their prehistoric ancestors were on an entirely different scale. Imagine a super croc so massive that it could challenge even the fiercest dinosaurs of its time. A true river monster, growing nearly twice the size of today's largest crocodiles and ruling its territory with unrivaled power. This was Sarcosuchus imperator, one of the largest crocodilian relatives to have ever lived. In this journey, we will delve into the fascinating world of this legendary predator, exploring its habitat, behavior, and hunting strategies while comparing it to modern crocodiles. Prepare to step back in time to an era ruled by giants and come face to face with one of history's most terrifying predators. Millions of years ago, the Sahara was not the vast, arid desert we see today. Instead, it was a lush, humid landscape, teeming with life, shaped by rivers and swamps that nurtured a diverse array of prehistoric creatures. Seasonal flooding created expansive wetlands, providing an ideal hunting ground for predators. This rich ecosystem, filled with towering dinosaurs, massive fish, and formidable reptiles, was home to one of the most fearsome predators of the early Cretaceous, Sarcosuchus imperator. Unlike modern crocodiles, this giant was not just a river-dwelling ambush predator, it was a true prehistoric monster. Growing up to 40 feet, 12 meters long, and weighing around 8 tons, Sarcosuchus was nearly twice the size of the largest crocodiles alive today. Its elongated snout, lined with over 100 razor-sharp conical teeth, made it a dominant force in its environment, capable of taking down a variety of prey, from massive fish to even young dinosaurs. Its powerful bite force allowed it to crush through thick bones and armored scales, ensuring few creatures could escape its deadly grasp. One of Sarcosuchus's most distinctive features was the bulla, a mysterious bulbous structure at the tip of its snout, giving it a striking resemblance to the modern-day gharial. Scientists are still debating its function, but some theories suggest it could have helped Sarcosuchus amplify its vocalizations, allowing it to communicate over long distances, much like modern crocodiles do when bellowing. Another possibility is that it played a role in enhancing its sense of smell or detecting vibrations in the water, making it an even more effective predator in murky river environments. Some researchers even speculate that the bulla could have been a display feature used to signal dominance or attract mates. Unlike modern crocodiles, which have shorter, more robust skulls designed for crushing, Sarcosuchus' long, narrow jaws indicate that it was likely a fish specialist, preying on massive prehistoric fish such as Mausonia and Lepidotes that thrived in the Cretaceous river systems. However, while its primary diet may have consisted of fish, some paleontologists speculate that it may have occasionally ambushed small to medium-sized dinosaurs that ventured too close to the water's edge. unlike Dinosuchus, a later crocodilian that had a more powerful bite suited for crushing bone, Sarcosuchus likely relied on its jaw strength and sharp teeth to grip and thrash prey, potentially using a death roll to tear apart its meals. Its powerful body, combined with its immense size, made it a dominant predator of its time, shaping the river ecosystems in ways similar to modern crocodiles today. Despite its resemblance to modern crocodiles, Sarcosuchus was not actually their direct ancestor. It belonged to an extinct group called Pholodosauridae, which were more distantly related to today's crocodilians than species like Dinosuchus or Purosaurus. This means that Sarcosuchus and modern crocodiles share a common ancestor, but they evolved separately over millions of years. Comparing its size to modern crocodilians puts things into perspective. Today's largest living crocodile, the saltwater crocodile, reaches a maximum of about 23 feet, 7 meters, and weighs around 2,200 pounds, 1 ton, making Sarcosuchus nearly twice as long and almost four times as heavy. If Sarcosuchus existed today, it would dwarf any crocodilian currently living on Earth. Sarcosuchus thrived in vast river systems during the early Cretaceous, where it coexisted with other massive aquatic predators. One of its likely competitors was Onchopristis, a giant sawfish armed with long, serrated rostral spines. Fossil evidence suggests that these enormous fish were abundant in the same waters as Sarcosuchus, and their remains have been found with bite marks that may have come from this colossal crocodilian. Unlike modern crocodiles, which prefer ambush tactics, Sarcosuchus may have actively hunted these massive fish in deep river channels. As the Cretaceous period progressed, environmental changes, shifting water systems, and competition from more specialized crocodilians contributed to the decline and eventual extinction of Sarcosuchus, paving the way for the rise of its more adaptable relatives. The true understanding of Sarcosuchus only became possible thanks to fossil discoveries by paleontologist Paul Sereno and his team in the 1990s, when they unearthed nearly complete remains in the Sahara Desert. These fossils allowed scientists to reconstruct its skull, body proportions, and even estimate its bite force and hunting behavior. Before these discoveries, Sarcosuchus was known only from fragmentary fossils, leading to speculation about its true size and nature. But with detailed reconstructions, we now know it was one of the largest crocodilian-like reptiles to ever exist. Further analysis of its growth rings suggested that Sarcosuchus grew continuously throughout its life, taking up to 50 or 60 years to reach its massive size. These findings have provided a deeper insight into how this apex predator dominated its prehistoric environment. Even though Sarcosuchus vanished over 100 million years ago, its fossils tell the story of an incredible predator that once dominated prehistoric waters. Imagine stepping into its territory, a murky river teeming with prehistoric life, not knowing that beneath the surface lurked a monster capable of snapping you in half in a single bite. Its immense size and powerful jaws made it one of the most fearsome predators of its time, ruling the waterways with unmatched dominance. The reign of Sarcosuchus may be long over, but its legacy remains in the fossils we uncover today, giving us a glimpse into a world where true river monsters once ruled, shaping the course of evolution for the crocodilians that followed. And thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to support the channel and stay tuned for more fascinating content.